Welcome to Six String Guitar, and we are going to do nothing but one other than Oasis' Wonderwall, one of their greatest all-time hits. And we're going to zoom in, we're going to take a look, and we're going to get the chord structure, the strumming. We're going to do it in the acoustic style from Noel Gallagher's and his brother Liam on their solo as well. So they do that in a in an acoustic form, so I'm gonna show you the acoustic form. If you like what you see, please subscribe to my channel, Six String Guitar. Hit that like button and smash that notification bell. Anyway, we're gonna zoom in and we're gonna get to the lesson. Hey, welcome back, and we're gonna take a look at Wonderwall by the one and only Oasis. So the very first thing is we're going to have to take our capo. If you want to do it in the original recording of Oasis. Now I've seen Liam going up on the third fret sometimes. But if you want to stick with the original version, keep the capo on the second fret. Again, from my other videos, I always say start that way. And then if you want to sing along, you got to try to experiment with the capo and see where it fits your voice. Anyway, so that is the first thing. The capo is on the second fret. Now the chord structure, the voicings in these, in the chords in this song, it's so nice. So the very first thing we're going to do, and what I would like to tell you, is we're going to anchor two of our fingers and they'll stay there for the majority of this song. So we're going to anchor our pinky on the third fret relative to the capo on the high E string on the first string on the third fret, and your ring finger up on top on the third fret of the second string or the B string, again relative to the capo. And the very first chord is an E minor 7. Now some people will play it like this, using their two fingers. I'll have the diagrams up there as well so you can see it. So if you want to play it like that, you can. I tend to play it barring off the two, the A and the D string on the second fret instead of doing that. It's an easier transition, but whatever you feel comfortable with. So it's E minor 7. Then it's a G or a G5. So all you're going to do is you're just going to keep these two fingers down. You're going to anchor those fingers down for all these chords in the song. G or G5. Now you can play a full G if you want to. And then you're going to do another beautiful chord. You're going to continue to keep your pinky and your ring finger there down on the first and second string of the third fret. You're going to let it, and you're going to do a D sus 4, which is like this, and you'll see the diagram, and you're going to strum. Or. And the next chord is an A 7 sus 4. You can do it, take this finger and go up one string. Or if you want to do an A major sus 4, you can bear these two. It's quite up to you. But I think Liam and Noel will do it that way. Either or works. Then you got another lovely chord. You're just going to C add 9. And the only other thing, there's a walk down on the course going from a G to an F sharp, which will bring you into your E minor. And I'll show you that as we get along. So that is the chords. So the strumming pattern, there's no set strumming pattern for this. You want to be able to do something like this, you know, it's count 16 notes and accent your strumming. So
Not straight strumming, just keep accenting the strums. What you could do is sometimes you start at the bottom or the lower register, and sometimes you skip and you bring up on the higher string, something like this. So something like, so down, so that is like a strumming pattern that you can go by. And like I say, start from the low end of the register, and sometimes you're going to accent the notes up from the bottom, or the, yeah, we'll call it the bottom, closest to the floor, with up strokes, and that's your accent, like. And so on. So this song has really three parts to it. Or four if you want to count the intro. The intro and the verses are pretty much the same. So I'm just going to quickly show you the intro. It's exactly what I just strummed there then. It's your E minor 7 to your D, to your G, sorry, to your D sus 4, to your A 7 sus 4. And that goes around 2-3 times, and I'm just going to play it for you. Here we go. So that is your intro. So when you get into the verse, it's the same thing. You do it three times, and on the end of verse one, it's a little bit different from verse two and three, because verse one goes back into a verse two, but on verse two and three at the end, it goes into the chorus. So I'll show you what happens here. So we're going to do the E minor 7, again like the intro, your G. G major, G5, whatever way you want to play it. D sus 4, A7 sus 4, and then back around again for two more times. So we're going to do that. And again, just keep your strumming light and accent the notes, and it should go to this speed. Here we go, let's try. So E minor 7, it starts on verse 1. One, two, three, so it goes around three times like that, and then to lead you into the next verse, you're going to do a C add 9. That'll lead you back into verse 2. So again, on the end of verse 1 and only verse 1 to get you into verse 2, you're going to do a C add 9, D sus 4, and A7 sus 4. Then you're back into verse 2. So I'm just going to play it all through for you one more time. I'm going to start with verse 1. And here we go, 1, 2, 3, 4. Mm-hmm. to verse 2. Verse 2 is exactly the same, but you stay on the E minor. And then we have a pre-chorus. And the pre-chorus chords are your C add 9, your D sus 4, your E minor 7, twice. And then it goes to a C add 9, D sus 4, to a G, and then we're going to walk down to an E minor 7, to a quick G, and to an A sus 4. So that is the pre-chorus, and it'll bring you into the chorus. So we're going to try it. Again, the same strumming, just a very light 16. Accent your notes in 16ths. So here we go. So, and all the roads around and us are winding. And you get my drift, right? Okay, so here we go. And all the roads. Twice on that, here we go. And into the chorus. And we're going to do that one more time. C add 9. And all the roads that lead us here are winding, right? Here's our part. There are many things that I would like to say to you, but I don't know how. Here is the chorus. All right, after the pre-chorus, we're into the chorus. And we have three chords, basically. We have the C add 9, E minor 7, G, back to E minor 7. And that happens four times. And it goes, I said maybe you're gonna be the one that saves me. So that's how it goes. It starts on your E minor 7, your C add 9, to your E minor 7, to your G, to your E minor 7, and goes back again four times. Here we go. I said maybe And then you're into the third verse again. But before you get to the third verse, you're going to strum your E minor 7 on the end here. Keep it for two measures. And then you're going to do a fast strum on the A7 sus 4. And you're back into the verse. Repeat the chorus again, and at the end there's like a tag. It's basically the same as the chorus. It goes, well, maybe I said maybe I said maybe. and the E minor 7.
Hope you like this lesson of Wonderwall by Oasis. If you like what you see, please subscribe to my channel. Six string guitar, hit that notification bell and smash that like button. Until the next time, keep picking and have fun.